So this first example is a good case for regularization. The load is mostly evenly distributed, so there is some regular sort of average case that you can shoot for that'll be relatively easy to predict. And then occasionally you'll have outliers and you can do something about them, such as dealing with them separately in another algorithm or on another processor, as we discussed before. So I would consider this a good case for regularization. It's likely that we can come up with a regularization strategy here that'll work. On the other hand, when the load varies wildly and it's not really easy to predict what is the average case, you have no idea when you start a process how long it's going to take or how many items you'll have to process, then I would say this is not an easy case for regularization, which is really sort of just restated in the final bullet. Obviously, for regularization, the whole goal is to extract regular parallelism from irregular parallelism. And so for that point, you'd kind of like to be able to know what is regular. So if you can predict where and how load imbalance is going to take place at runtime, then you can structure the application to deal with the load balancing on the spot. So when load is relatively evenly distributed, it's almost regular already, and dealing separately with occasional irregularities is likely to work. If the load varies wildly, then it's harder to know what to regularize to, and it's much easier to regularize the workload if you can predict what that workload is going to be.